Welcome and good evening, race fans. The clock is ticking down to the start of today's practice session here at the Marina Bay Street Circuit, the setting for this weekend's Singapore Grand Prix. You have to say, since its inaugural Grand Prix back in 2008, Singapore has been a great Formula One success story. It was Formula One's first ever night race, taking place under these powerful spotlights, with the different coloured lights in the city surrounding the circuit. It definitely makes for a fantastic racing experience for both the drivers and for the fans.
It's certainly fantastic for the fans, but a huge challenge for the drivers. Racing at night is one thing, but on top of that, you're in amongst the barriers on an incredibly bumpy surface, not to mention the extreme humidity that drivers face. All of this makes it the most physically and mentally demanding race on the calendar.
This is the kind of track that eats rear tyres for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
No matter how good a driver is at managing their throttle application to limit rear slip, they can't always overcome a car that's inherently bad at looking after its rear tyres. Here we have a lot of low-speed corner exits, which means a whole load of energy, heat and tyre wear.
Lewis Hamilton has recorded the fastest time of the day in today's practice session. The British driver will be mightily pleased with just how well his car performed. Sky is dark and the lights are on. Welcome to qualifying here at the Marina Bay Street Circuit in Singapore. How will Nico Rosberg be approaching this qualifying session?
Well, he'll know that it's crucial to start this race in pole position, so he has to deliver the maximum when it really matters. We all know he's got the speed in qualifying. He's shown that time and time again. But now's the time to make it happen.
Checks complete. All personnel be aware, we have a car leaving.
This lap. Good job.
Valtteri Bottas has put in a fantastic performance today, and one that I think he and the whole team can be very proud of.
Well, they've shown the car has great pace today, but they'll need to demonstrate what it can do over the race duration if they are to secure the victory tomorrow.
It's Sunday evening here at the Marina Bay Street Circuit, and the cars are being prepared for what is going to be a fascinating event. It's time for the Singapore Grand Prix. The pole sitter today is Valtteri Bottas, but there have been worries all weekend about the clutch on his Williams. If he can't get the bite point correct, well, he'll be a sitting duck off the line.
You can never be sure if qualifying pace will turn into race performance. It often depends on how focused the car setup was for a single lap on new tyres. But even if he's slightly slower than those around him, he'll be trying to make his car as wide as possible on track to defend his position.
So what would you have been doing overnight if you were Lewis Hamilton to make up the time difference that he needs to make up based on yesterday's qualifying times?
He clearly has a pretty good balance in the car. He just needs to work out where he can squeeze an extra tenth or two to make up the difference.
is now enabled. Be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car head in the DRS zone. wind is on stern and left. Now all wind is within stern and left. just 2 seconds.
Thank you.
chance of this going out. Rosberg has just made a pass for the lead.
Impressive to see how well that Williams looked out on track. It had the perfect balance and was driven with precision to achieve the race win.
Indeed, they'll be ecstatic with that result, and they should be. It was a fantastic drive.
After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us, and goodbye until the next race.